Yeah, but I think anybody who's about to embark upon a mission to try and become the best golfer on earth for a set period of time shouldn't take chances on the sort of stairs he uses.
Yeah, but I don't think he's taking a chance by renting a home and walking up and down stairs. But sometimes accidents happen. That's why they're called accidents.
Yeah.
I mean, you must have had accidents in your life. I mean, people have them.
I've not had too many accidents because I look after myself properly.
Yeah, but when you have an accident, the point is that, you know, you don't expect to have it. Yeah. That's why it's called an accident.
Well, it's all completely his fault. It's nobody else's fault.
Well, you don't know that.
Well, of course it's his fault.
How do you know that?
Well, who else is to blame, then?
Well, it's being called a freak accident.
A freak accident? Yeah. And what's freakish about it?
A freak accident means something which is, generally speaking, beyond your control.
You mean freakish?
A freakish. It may be beyond your control.
Yeah.
I mean, I fell down the stairs once when I was in my place in Glasgow.
Yeah.
Right?
But
wasn't so much a freak accident as my carelessness, right? But it was because I was...
Well, most of the time you lived in Glasgow.
One of the stuff... You don't know anything about when I lived in Glasgow. You were never there. You were never in Glasgow. Did you ever come and see me when I lived in Glasgow?
Didn't you suspend all...
Did you ever come and see me when I lived in Glasgow?
Didn't you
Did you ever come and see me when I lived in Glasgow?
Did you...
Yes or no?
Did you used to spend all nights in nightclubs in Glasgow and then go back to work next morning?
That's not true. No.
Why have you told people that story, then?
Well, I went to nightclubs occasionally, like everybody does.
And stayed all night?
No, I didn't stay all night. I stayed until about 4 or 5 in the morning, which is not all night.
Oh, really?
Are you going to be like this tonight? Is this what it's going to be like? Am I going to have to start getting horrible to you again? I'm nice to you for a couple of days, and then you start trying to push the buttons. Is that what you're going to do?
Till 5 a.m. is usually all night to most people,
It's not.
It's just a late night for you, is it?
Yeah, it's just a late night. What, you think going out till 5 is all night? No, going out all night is not going home till 7 in the morning.
Oh, I say, okay, it's not 5 a.m.
But because you don't live with anyone and never have, you don't have that particular rule. Do you want to hear my story or not?
What's it about?
About how I fell down the stairs.
Right, go on then, yeah.
Right, the reason I fell down the stairs was because I was carrying something, right?
Right.
And when you are carrying something, which he might have been doing...
And you weren't inebriated?
I wasn't, actually, no.
Right,
you can sometimes lose your footing because the stairs were particularly tight in this particular apartment I was in.
Yeah,
because it was quite small.
Right.
And they were almost a spiral-type stair. And if you went down too close to the inside of it, and one of your feet slipped and you fell...
Yeah.
You weren't able to stop yourself. Normally, if you slip and there's a banister, you can hold on to it.
Well, if your hands are full, you can.
But if your hands are full, you can't. And as a result of that, I cracked a rib.
Well, that was very poor preparation, wasn't it, using those stairs?
What are you talking about?
Well, if they're difficult to negotiate stairs in the first place, and you try and do it without knowing you can use your arms as assistance because your arms are full of a package, that's a pretty stupid thing to do,
isn't it? Well, you can say that, but that's why accidents happen, because usually people do things which are stupid. You know, not everybody is
imbued. That's what he might have done, then.
Well, he might have done, but that doesn't mean that it's not an accident. I don't understand why, because you can't admit ever making a mistake, that you can't admit that sometimes
not
other people make mistakes.
Not at all. What I'm saying is,
gotten into you today?
To be perfectly honest, I think the fact that you're not smoking anymore is really getting to you, because you...
Well, I was fine
yesterday. You flare up with
I was fine when I came in. You started telling me what I did when I was in Scotland, when you never, ever came to Scotland to see what I was doing.
I asked you, did you stay out tonight in a nightclub?
No,
three
I did
times
not.
You tried to evade the question, and you finally answered it and said, yes, you did, till 5 a.m.
in
the morning.
But not every night.
Oh, I said, did you ever?
No, you didn't. You said you were always out every night drinking until 5 in the morning.
I didn't. I said you stayed in nightclubs all night. Well, I'm sorry if you got annoyed. I think you should take up smoking again and get your sense of humour back.
You think I should get my sense of humour back? Okay, fine. All right, let's start again, shall
we? Listen, if you're going to prepare yourself to win the Masters Golf, the last thing you should be doing is taking chances on stairs which are not completely easy to navigate up or down.
Well, maybe you should have rented a bungalow, is that what you're saying?
I'm saying...
You're being ridiculous.
No, I'm not. What I'm saying is, you've got to conduct yourself with great care if you're one of the most famous sportsmen in the world, and you're about to enter into one of the most famous competitions in the world, and you suddenly make a domestic error...
But we don't know what happened, that's the point.
Which could cost you... competing in that tournament.
He's in some discomfort, right? Yeah. He's being given anti-inflammatory medication to ease the pain, so he's not necessarily out of the whole tournament.
Yeah.
However, it could well be that he's hurt his back in such a way that he won't be able to play in the way that he could. Mm. But the point is, I think you'd be a little hard on him. The guy, one, we don't know exactly how he did it.
No.
And two, we don't know exactly what he could have done to prevent it. And if you rent a house and you've got your family living with you and it happens to have stairs, you're going to have to negotiate the stairs. You know, there's only so many things you can do. I mean, you are the same man who, by the way, said, when I said that Rory McIlroy, was rather foolish to have played football and injured his ankle.
Yes.
That, you know, the young man should be allowed to do whatever he wants.
Mm.
So you're now taking a completely different tack on this guy.
No, I'm not. No,
yeah, you are.
No, I'm not taking a different tack at all. I said that Rory McIlroy, as the, I think he was a champion golfer at the time before he entered into the competition.
He was, but he started playing five-a-side football.
Yeah, started playing five-a-side football, but I mean, that is a harmless pursuit if you're on a level playing field and you're just kicking a ball. Where he went wrong was, he went wrong by not having a duty of care to the way he was playing football, and I would suggest that this guy as well has somehow not taken a duty of care in looking after the way he walks up and down stairs on the eve of the Masters.
So it's all right for Rory McIlroy to play football, but it's not all right for Dustin Johnson to go up the stairs.
It's all right for anybody to do whatever they want and behave in any way they want, as long as they don't put themselves in peril in relation to whatever their profession is. So, you know, for instance, if you were if you're a darts player or a piano player, and you suddenly decide that it's be a good idea to have a bare-knuckle boxing match the night before the finals of your competition, it's not a good idea.
Well, that's not really the same as living in a house with stairs, is it?
But well,
we can talk to Bob Bupka later on about this,
because
Bob Bupka will be telling us precisely what he knows about it, what happened. Here's one from Maxwell. He says, some people might say Porky is a freak accident. Not me, though, just some people. Pete says, the clue is in the name, freak accident. It's an accident. Hashtag Dustin Johnson.
Well,
and Eric says, not sure why Porky isn't hypothesising bladderation as a theory behind Dustin Johnson's situation.
Well, I wouldn't actually, because I do believe that elite sportsmen of his calibre actually don't get involved in the bladderation
trial.
I'm not
even sure
certainly,
he drinks actually, Dustin Johnson.
No, exactly. Certainly not on the eve of a competition like
Dr.
that.
Dr. Lowell says this, hilarious, great start. I agree with Porky. I think falling down the stairs sounds a bit suspicious.
Yeah, and me. And me.
You think it's suspicious?
Well, no, I'm not saying it's suspicious. What I'm saying is, I think that there's a duty of care to yourself when you're on the eve of the major competition, which forms the,
the
cornerstone of your workplace.
Yeah, but if you've got to go up the stairs, you've got to go up the stairs. I mean, what else are you supposed to do?
I would like to know a little bit more about what actually happened there, to be honest.
Well, let's find out from Bob Bupka later on, the voice of golf. He may well know. He may well have a better idea. But at the moment, all we are being told is that it was a freak accident. We're not being told whether it happened as he was going up the stairs.
Freak accidents cover a multitude of sins.
Well,
they
do.
Yeah.
And whether he was coming down the stairs or when he went up the stairs, you went to grab. I mean, surely you've been in a situation where you've gone to grab for something and somehow you miss.
Yes, I have.
And that can happen.
Yeah.
And then suddenly you fall.
I don't think I've ever had an
accident. Have you never fallen over?
I've fallen over.
Have you ever fallen over? You must have done.
Yeah, I had a fall once.
You told me you fell down the stairs at some
tube
station.
I did when I was inebriated.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, I mean, was that a freak accident?
No.
What was that?
Well, that was an accident brought on by the fact that I was unsteady on my feet because of the bladderation tendencies of what I'd been doing for the previous three
years. And you've done that once?
Yeah, but I never went around saying to people, oh, you know, it was a freak accident. It wasn't. I was drunk. And as a result of which, my behaviour wavered from its normal impeccable 100% of care.
You spend most of your life drunk. You should have been used to walk down the stairs.
No.
What on earth is Porky waffling on about, says Andrew?
Well, if you'd have listened, you'd have heard. But unfortunately, you know,
well,
because of your bellicose response to my reasonable questioning.
Even for Porky, this is an amazing amount of absolute nonsense.
No, it's not. It's an absolute nonsense.
Nobody is agreeing with you.
Well, you see, that's the problem with you, Mike. You like to go with the crowd.
Oh,
sometimes
really?
You have to stand alone and say,
no. I don't like to go with the crowd at all. You're the one that likes to be Mr. Popular.
No, you do. Not at all.
You are constantly changing your view on the world, depending on what you think people are going to want to hear.
Not at all.
But never mind. We've got lots of football to talk about.
We've
got Simon Johnson, who was down at Chelsea. Manchester City seems to have given up the ghost. We'll talk about Pep Guardiola.
Yep.
We'll talk about Spurs and Mauricio Pochettino. We'll talk as well about, who are you? Ian Holloway.
Yes.
He's having some kind of feud with the owners of Aston
with
Villa.
With the Villa chairman, absolutely.
Yeah, good stuff.
Mr. Zia.
This is Talk Sport.
What's going on? Correct about the truth. Help about the truth. What's going on?